The Scheme Villain's Self-Saving System, Chapter 78, Past Faces Long Gone 1, Audio Source, WhoshaWorldAudiobook.com. Chapter 78, Past Faces Long Gone 1. Shen Qingchu said, "That's not the problem. Luo Bingo wouldn't let it go. Then what is the problem?" Shen Qingchu raised his fan. "Let's settle our current task first. We can talk about it later." Luo Binge slowly retreated, smiling faintly. "Fine," he said softly. "Either way, there's a plenty of time to talk about it later." Everyone present could sense countless numbers of creatures stirring, hidden beneath the surface of the dark thicket of branches, waist-high brush, and piles of deathly pale stone all around. Lustrous green eyes and whispering pants rose and fell like tiny waves. At this time, the advantage of having Luo Bingo walk in front was fully apparent. As long as it was him facing the direction they were walking, the sinister winds would immediately pause, and not a single voice would be heard. Two, the hidden demonic beasts would either play dead in force or frantically stream into retreat. To say it a bit coarsely, it was like they were fleeing a god of pestilence. With this godly assistance, the time it took to reach their destination was much shorter than anticipated. If there was suddenly a column of roiling black energy rushing into the sky in the middle of a field of curling white fog, anyone who wasn't blind could see the anomaly. The cavern mouth was hidden by layer upon layer of thick green leaves, dark as an overcast forest. Standing beside the cave mouth would give anyone a fit of chills. Their party halted their footsteps in hesitation. According to his original imagings, before reaching this stage they should have had to kill 800 enemy generals, chopped up 1,000 demonic beasts, and met all sorts of poisonous insects and strange flowers on the way before they could reach the last hurdle after thousands of trials and tribulations. Even if there weren't that many formalities, shouldn't they have at least gotten some blood on their clothes before they were worthy of the boss fight? One of the sect leaders said, "I'm afraid we cannot make a rash move." Another agreed, "It's best if we scout out the real situation first." Luo Bingo said, "That's for sure." He had just finished speaking when Mo Beijun suddenly kicked Shang Qinghua out. He really just kicked him out, out, out. Right in front of Shen Qingchu's astonished gaze, Shang Qinghua rolled and fell into the cavern to scout out the real situation. After a moment of deathly stillness, a wretched screech suddenly exploded out from inside the cave. Ah! At lightning speed, Shen Qingchu shoved aside a handful of vines to pour into the cavern with the others when he heard a voice sound out, "Peak Lord Shen, we meet again." 3. The Sinmo sword was stuck in a crack in the rock at the far end of the cavern. That black energy and purple smoke were spilling from its point. Tian Langjun sat atop a piece of limestone, Shang Qinghua standing not far from the rock. Natural light from outside the cave flowed in, illuminating half of Tian Langjun's body. Immediately, some drew in a cold breath. Shen Qingchu finally knew why Shang Qinghua's earlier screech was so wretched. Even though the smile on Tian Langjun's face was as elegant as before, almost half the right side of his face had rotted into a purple-black mass, making this smile an extremely frightful sight. His left sleeve was deflated, empty. Apparently, that arm which kept falling off couldn't be reattached anymore. This dilapidated appearance, a dry lamp out of oil, was far from the final boss Shen Qingchu had imagined. Shen Qingchu couldn't resist taking a glance at Luo Bingo's expression. But, his face only held a nearly wooden calm, an emotion he couldn't decipher. Tian Langjun tilted his head, saying, "Fewer came than imagined. I had thought it would be like last time at Beilu Mountain with hundreds of experts coming into battle." Wu Wang snorted, Look at this appearance of yours. Human but not human, demon but not demon. You don't even have a single lackey by your side. Do we even need that many people to come? Tian Langjun said, it's true that I don't have a lackey here, but I do have a nephew. Before his words had fallen, a green shadow flashed across the cavern mouth. Without a breath of sound, Zhu Jilang blocked in front of Tian Langjun. For some reason, this master-servant pair were both in a sorry state. Tian Langjun's Zhu flower body wasn't suited to demonic energy and had rotted until it was full of holes. This was understandable, but Zhu Jilang also had pupils suffused with yellow, plate after plate of scales crawling up to cover his neck, cheeks, forehead, arms, and all exposed skin. It was a frightful and sinister sight, very close to his half-human half-snake form in the Zhu flower cave. He said hoarsely, Master Shen. Shen Qingchu said, it's me. How did you end up like this? Yue Qingyuan said, not batting an eyelid. Shidi, you have some relationship with this person. A deep relationship indeed. For in the course of events up until today, he had had the most important sort of connection with this person. Shen Qingchu was just about to speak when Tian Langjun faintly raised his chin, squinting at Yue Qingyuan. I remember you, he thought, then said, certain. At that time, that old man from Wanhua Palace wanted you to help him mount a sneak attack, but you didn't pay him any attention. Now, the Kangqiong Mountain sect leader is you. Not bad, Yue Qingyuan said. Sire, your memory is not bad as well. Tian Langjun smiled, then let out a sigh. If you are also suppressed in a pitch-black place for decades, never seeing the sun, with only the option of thinking of things past to while away the time every day, your memory would be not bad just like mine. This time, no one responded. Yue Qingyuan gripped Xuan Su, striking out with sword and scabbard included. Tian Langjun was just about to dodge the strike when, with waves of rumbling, half the cave wall behind him collapsed, opening a big hole. The outside was high in the air, flying sand and rolling stones tumbling to drop down in a fall. The cold air suddenly rolled in, fine snowflakes dancing through the air to confuse everyone's sight. Wave surging over wave of beastly cries and the sounds of battle faintly floated up from the ice surface hundreds of meters below. The first wave of southern border demons had already touched ground. Tian Langjun said, I'd guess, it's definitely Bizan Peak fighting on the front lines again. Am I right? Dozens of people had scattered, each charging over from every angle. Wu Wang, brandishing his spiritual staff into a formidable wind, extremely firm and fierce, stole to the very front. Zhu Jilang was pushed to retreat step by step by Xuan Su, but still diligently drew a good part of the firepower. Tian Langjun continued to sit on the limestone and said leisurely, I remember at that time, you dragged it out until the very last moment to draw your sword. Will you do the same today? Yue Qingyuan didn't respond. Just when he was about to send a palm strike at Zhu Jilang's chest, another sect leader stole AEAD to strike first. Zhu Jilang didn't dodge or retreat, taking the full force of the strike, but the one who let out a wretched scream was actually that sect leader. Shen Qingchu's pupils suddenly contracted. He yelled, don't touch him, his body is covered in poison. In the chaos of battle, a few people were poisoned, a few others jolted out of the cave by the bursts of demonic energy and spiritual energy. Their bodies thrown out in mid-air, they would flip onto their swords mid-fall and steady themselves. Shang Qinghua surreptitiously slid towards Shen Qingchu. Zhu Jilang was caught in the raging bloodlust of battle, and unexpectedly seeing a furtive figure sneaking towards the outside, reflexively flung over two green snakes. Seeing this, Shen Qingqiu flicked his hand, a green leaf flying out to save Airplane Zhu's life, when the two green snakes were suddenly skewered by a sharp spike of ice solidifying out of mid-air. Mo Beijun appeared in the middle of the battle like a ghost, picked up Shang Qinghua, tossed him at Shen Qingqiu like tossing a chicken, and smashed a fist towards Zhu Jilang. In the next 10 seconds, Shen Qingqiu finally witnessed firsthand what could be called a vicious beating. With Zhu Jilang suffering Mo Beijun's wild beating, the firepower directed at Tian Langjun suddenly heightened. Though Tian Langjun was down an arm and fighting one on many, his elegant poise still didn't drop a pinch. "Eh, why are you like this again? Fighting many on one, don't you think you're winning without a fight, violating the rules of justice?" One sect leader rushed to attack. "Towards you, this type of demon race monster harboring evil intentions, fearing that any part of the world is not in chaos, what justice is there to be said?" The next moment, his head exploded into pieces like a clove of garlic. Tian Langjun smiled. "Actually, I didn't really have any evil intentions at first, and I wasn't quite interested in seeing the whole world in chaos. I would occasionally cross the border and come to this side to sing some songs and read some books. It was very nice. But, now that I've stayed under Beilu Mountain for that many years, I'm a bit reluctant not to do some of those things you're thinking of." Yue Qingyu inflicted his finger. Xuanzu unsheathed by 3 inches, spiritual energy exploding up. Tian Langjun's body creaked like his skeleton was shifted out of alignment, making a sound of surprise. "Sure enough, you're a sect leader. Very good." Your Shifu himself wasn't much to speak of, but his eye in picking disciples and successes was quite good. He reached out a hand, directly grabbing Xuanzu's point. He smiled as if he was ignorant and unaware of everything around him. "But why don't you draw it completely? Just like this, you still can't do anything to me." Yue Qingyuan's gaze darkened, and Xuanzu drew out another half inch. Suddenly, he heard Luo Binga say coldly, "He can't do anything to you. What about me?" Tian Langjun had not yet shared his smile when, suddenly, a strong stream of demonic energy surged over, chopping down like a machete. His only remaining hand shed its arm and flew out of the cavern, swept up by a wild gale, falling straight down Mai Gu Ridge. Luo Binga finally showed his hand. This father-son pair once again faced off, and this time, it was finally Tian Langjun who had no power to retaliate. Luo Binga's eyes were glaringly red, his face stretched taut, his strikes ruthless and tyrannical, not allowing any mercy. Now, both of Tian Langjun's hands were gone. Even with his left arm and right stump, he was pushed to his limits. When Zhu Jilang broke away from Mo Beijun's, his face and body were already a mass of blood and flesh. Seeing his master hard-pressed, it was like he had lost his head in the melee, crashing his way straight over. Right at that time, Wu Wang had been brushed by Tian Langjun's demonic energy flying backward and spewing a mouthful of blood as Great Master Wu Chen went to catch him. Seeing Zhu Jilang about to collide with him, Shen Qingqiu knew the situation was taking a bad turn. He flashed over to block in front of Wu Chen. Upon seeing Shen Qingqiu, a wisp of clarity flashed through Zhu Jilang's glistening yellow pupils. He violently braked, losing his balance and nearly stumbling into a fall. Just when he was going to detour around Shen Qingqiu to go help Tian Langjun, a flash of white light suddenly shot across the scene. Zhu Jilang's back heavily thudded into the cave wall, nailed into the cliff rock through his chest. That half-length of slender sword blade in his chest was precisely Zheng Yang 6. Shen Qingqiu turned, and Luo Binga slowly pulled back. Tian Langjun stood serenely some meters behind him. He only stood for a while, then gracefully collapsed to the ground. The battle is over. It was this easy. Shen Chengchu still felt this was a bit unacceptable. He didn't even get in a few strikes. And they're done just like this. He smacked Shang Qinghua. Didn't you say Tian Langjun was very hard to fight? Shang Qinghua said. It is very hard, Shen Chengchu. Is there any logic to this win? Shang Qinghua. No matter how difficult a boss, don't even think of making a wave in front of the male protagonist. Isn't this the publicly known logic? The two looked all around. There were dozens of people when they came, but now, in this blood-filled scene, only a few were left standing. Shen Chengchu looked at the two he used to regard as a boss level of extreme difficulty. One was nailed to the wall, dripping blood. One was lying on the ground, fitting the description of ragdoll, trampled and strings broken, 100%. He didn't feel the unrestrained satisfaction of defeating the final boss a bit. The more he looked, the more it felt like his side was bullying the old and the disabled, like a shameless gang beating. That's right, this definitely was a gang beating. But who knew it would become like this? The boss's actual strength fell too far from their expectations. Luo Bing turned, not yet died by a drop of blood. Calm and composed, he asked Shen Chengchu, "Do you want to kill him?" He was pointing at Tian Langjun. Zhu Zhilang heard and grabbed Zheng Yang's blade, straining to pull it out. Many of the scales on his neck and face had been scraped off in the chaos of battle, and with these bursts of strength, blood began to pour down in streams. Ever since he knew Gong Yixiao had been killed by him, Shen Chengchu always felt a bit of discomfort in his heart. But this scene really was a spectacle too horrible to endure, and it was hard for onlookers not to sympathize. And, even though Shen Chengchu had been afflicted by his strange method of repaying gratitude countless times, at the very least Zhu Zhilang had never held any evil intentions towards him. Shen Chengchu sighed. You've already gotten to this state. Why bother? Zhu Zhilang coughed out a mouthful of bloody foam, saying hoarsely. Got into this state? He smiled bitterly. If I said that my appearance at Beilu Mountain was my original body, what would Master Shen think? A peal of thunder crashed onto Shen Chengchu's forehead. What, that snake man crawling all over the ground on Beilu Mountain was actually Zhu Zhilang's original form? Zhu Zhilang gasped a breath and said, my lineage is humble. Just because my father was a primal giant snake, I was in this deformed half-human half-snake shape when my mother gave birth to me. Up until I was 15, others would always shun me and hate me, insult me and beat me. If my lord never helped me gain a human form and support me, I would be a monster squirming on the ground my whole life. He clenched his teeth and said, my lord gave me my first chance to become human, and you, Master Shen, gave me my second. Maybe it was merely the wave of a hand to you both, but to me, it's a debt I'd pursue through 10,000 deaths. Master Shen is asking me, why bother? You tell me why I bother. Tian Langjun suddenly sighed. Silly child, why are you telling him so much? Even though he was lying on the ground, he was as graceful and poised as ever. If you ignored the half of his face which had been corroded by demonic energy, he would be even more graceful and poised. He gazed at the sky and continued pensively. People always believed that, those of different clans, their hearts must travel different paths. 7. But, no matter how close someone is to you, they could betray you in the blink of an eye. Why have you always clung to your one-sided wish of repaying gratitude? No matter how much you say, he won't understand you. He'll only get fed up and not comprehend. Why do you need to say any more? For a while, everyone on the scene stayed in silence. A good-natured youth who had had no vicious intentions. full-heartedly enjoying discussions of love, only to find it was nothing but a trap, and then suppressed under a dark and sunless mountain for countless days and nights. WarsharWorldAudio.com. Who had the right to tell you him not to hold a grudge? Who had the right to tell you him? Let it go, get over it. But, great master Wu Chen said, if Sire truly did not hold these intentions in the past, it was our wrong to have believed slanderous charges. But you cannot hide or flee from today's disaster. Every evil cause will bring about evil fruits. Sooner or later they will all be repaid. He clasped his hands and said, but Miss Su didn't hesitate to take the poison and wanted to go see you. How can you blame her for betraying you? Tian Langjun started slightly, raising his head. Shen Qingchu also felt his heart tremble. Great Master Wu Chen would never tell a lie, but the version of events he told seemed to be a bit different from the one other people told and knew. Great Master Wu Chen said, at Zhao Hua Temple, because I didn't want Miss Su to suffer criticism after her death, and because I agreed to protect the secret, this old monk could not talk and explain the true facts. Miss Su was forcibly detained in Wanhua Palace by the old palace master. She was stubborn and refused to take orders. She wasn't willing to trick you to the ambush location which had been set up with dozens of suppressing spells. The old palace master only discovered that she was already pregnant when he was punishing her in the water prison. He feared that forcing an abortion would endanger her life, and Miss Su was even more willing to resist at all costs. So, the old palace master gave her a bowl of poison, a type of poison deadly to the demon race, and told her that as long as she was willing to drink it, he would let her go to see you. Miss Su drank the old palace master's drug and set off alone. But she didn't know that the old palace master had changed the ambush location to the Beilu Mountain where you two used to meet. In his shattered body, Tian Langjun strove to lift his head. A blood stain was still drying on his lip and, in a daze, he indeed had a kind of unspeakably pathetic appearance. This old monk met Miss Su on the road to Beilu Mountain. At that time, it was not long after she had drunk the drug, and her whole body was covered in blood, leaving crimson trails with every step. I heard her say a few fragments in explanation, and couldn't bear to deceive her. After I told her the truth about how Tian Langjun had already been suppressed for good, she finally knew that all her Shifu had told her was a towering lie. Not only was the location incorrect, but the time was too. At her request, this old monk protected her and helped her evade the Wanhua Palace disciples on patrol, sending her to the upper reaches of the Luochuan River. From then on, I didn't know any more traces of her whereabouts. Tian Langjun's, maybe it's true that Miss Su wasn't a purely benevolent person. She, the Wanhua Palace successor with high hopes piled on her, was originally set up high. In the beginning, she may have gotten close to you without good intentions. But in the end, between the two of you, was it you who bewitched her with malicious intent or her who couldn't keep a handle on her emotions? This old monk was not a player in this affair, and I never knew any of these truths. But from what I saw and what I knew, she really did reject the orders of the Shifu who had raised her for decades and didn't open her mouth even after suffering all kinds of torture in the water prison. Refusing to trick you or harm you if in the end she wasn't pushed to using a last resort, which mother in this world would drink that bowl of poison? She did not abandon and reject you, but had no other alternative. No one in this world pitied her, you just missed the opportunity, eh? Tian Langjun's lips seemed to tremble. After a while, he said, is that so? He finished these three words. Then, he asked, it's true? Great Master Wu Chen said, this old monk would swear on his life, not half a sentence of these words were false. Tian Langjun turned his head, looking at Shenqing Chu and Yue Qingyuan, and asked as if searching for confirmation. It's true. He didn't even care if the onlookers knew the truth of the situation, asking every person he could find. Yue Qingyuan faced him, wordless, silently lowering his head and pondering something unknown. Shenqing Chu thought it over again and again before finally slowly nodding his head. Perhaps the old palace master didn't hold any intent of slander and injury at first, but seeing the two gradually grow closer, he began to regret sending Su Xian to approach Tian Langjun. Su Xian had lost control of the situation and actually fell in love with Tian Langjun wholeheartedly, even having Luo Binga. This was the straw that broke the camel's back. Then, the old palace master produced evidence out of context, gave short measure, wove a series of events, and cast Tian Langjun straight into the role of an exceptional devil hungering to topple the three realms, and plainly wrecked this many people for this many years. Tian Langjun seemed to suddenly lose all his strength, once again collapsing to the ground. He sighed. All right. At least, there's one thing that wasn't that terrible. A few snowflakes dotted his eyelashes, trembling into motion. He didn't know whether it was this first snowfall to grace his brow in decades, or solidified, unfallen tears. Shenqing Chu turned to look at Luo Binga. He had listened from beginning to end but seemed as if he had heard nothing at all, even letting out a quiet chuckle. After explaining all these events, the knot gnawing at Tian Langjun's heart had been untied. But to Luo Binga, the degree of cruelty had not lowered a bit. It had only gone from the result of being rejected by mother and father to the result of being given up on by mother and father. He was the one who was given up on just like before. The Sinmo sword was still emitting a steady flow of purple-black energy, and the sounds of battle below grew clearer and clearer. It seemed that the descent of Maigu Ridge was continuing, some unknown distance from the iced over surface of the Luochuan. Yue Qingyuan walked a few steps towards the cliff wall pierced by the Sinmo sword. Shenqing Chu said, "Things are already like this. Tian Langjun, you should withdraw." If he withdrew now, it still was not too late. But if Tian Langjun continued to pour demonic energy into the Sinmo sword, the only way to stop the merge would really be to kill him. How to say, Shenqing Chu did not especially wish for Tian Langjun to actually die. After all, for the youth who liked to speak of love to become like this really was enough of a tragedy. If they were to take his life as well, where could you find a boss this miserable? But, Tian Langjun suddenly let out a laugh. That laugh resounded through the cavern and the mountain ridge. He seemed to find the situation extremely comical, tilting his head and saying, "Peak Lord Shen, look at how I am now. I can't even maintain Zhu Jilang's human shape." At this time, Shenqing Chu had not yet detected the meaning within his words, only faintly feeling his heart jump in his chest. Tian Langjun drawled, "I fought with you people for this long, and the toll on this body of mine could not be said to be small. Think about it, the one who's been supplying the Sinmo sword with demonic energy this whole time, who could that be?" These words were not spoken especially fast or slow, but after they entered Shenqing Chu's ear, it was a sentence or word. Hearing him, his neck gradually stiffened as though he had fallen into an icy rift. "You should indeed tell someone to withdraw. It's just that, that person is not me. Xi Wan Yan 2 Yi 3 Xi 4, the Xian in this is pronounced the same as Su Xian. Yan is the same character, probably intentional. Ya 1 Q 4 Wu 2 Sheng 1, lit. Crow and peacock make no sound. Zun 4 Lei 2 Bu 4 G 2 Yan 3 Er 3, lit. Rapid thunderbolt, no time to cover ears. This is sort of a play on the term for relationship used here. 1 Yuan 2 Yuan, with the characters for deep pool and Oregon. Bu for Jian for Tian Wan Ri for literally translates as never seeing the sky, heaven or the sun. As an idiom, can mean a world without justice or suffering oppression. Luo Bing'er's original sword he was using at Quiet Peak before Sin Mo, Heart Devil Sword. Fei 1 Wo 3 Zu 2 Lei 4 Chi 2 Sin 1 by 4 Yi 4 Lit. Not my clan, their heart must be different. A saying from the Zhao Zhuan, end chapter.